Hello guys, welcome back. Me and Wolf and his combo that's under the bench once more, we say hi to every one of you. And our model. The varnish is dry and as you can see, it's an incredible beauty. It's absolutely gorgeous. So, what we're going to do now? First of all, the first thing we're going to do is place some rings all over the deck. That it's a step that I have skipped before because I needed to varnish everything. So, I have to place rings. I'm not going to place the rings for the cannons yet, just the rings on the deck. And after that, we'll see what else do we need to place. So, let me get ready, because the rings are right here. These are the rings, and I believe we're going to need also these. Sorry guys, the camera was off, I was looking at the rings. These are the rings I'm going to use, and this, definitely these ones too. So, let me get ready and I'll get back to you. Guys, before placing the rings, I have to do another thing that I have forgot to tell you. I have to reopen all these holes in each and every one, every platform, because definitely some of these holes are closed from the varnish. Also, I have to do the same thing to each gun port, because after the rings, probably I'm going to deal in a couple of steps with the ropes for the gun ports. Nothing difficult about that, just a hand drill, the appropriate drill tip, and reopen all the holes. So let me do that and I'll get back to you to place the rings. So guys, first I'm going to open up holes over here. I'm going to open up one hole in each plank. There are six planks, so six holes. The holes must be at the far side of each side, right here. I'm going to use a 0.8mm drill to open the holes, because I need to be where the camera is. I'm going to open the holes and I'll get back to you. Let's do one together, it's not hard, and I will do the rest on my own. You get the ring, use some kind of tool to open the ring up. I'm trying to do that through the camera, so it's pretty hard. That's hard, especially through the camera. So, I have one. Let me do the others, because I need 12. And I'll get back to you to place them on the deck. Let's place them. I will glue them later when I have them in their final position. So let me put them all and I'll get back to you. The rings are in place. Now I have to do the rest of the rings in the entire deck. So let me find out where the rings are going to be from the schematics. I'll place them, nothing special about that, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. So guys, as you can see, I have placed the rings all over the decks. Also two rings here attached on the anchor supports. Each ring that it goes directly behind the cannon has another ring attached in. You can see that over here, also over here. The rings that are goes around the masts are just rings, like here, and also all the other rings. It wasn't difficult, just time consuming. Now, I'm going to do, also, let me, I forgot to tell you, I have placed the rings here, and also at the rear of the stern, for the chains, but I haven't glued them. As you can see, it moves, because all the rings, except this one that has another ring in on it, because when I'm going to place the chain, I have to be able to open up the ring so I can insert the chain. And if I have glued them, that would be almost impossible without destroying the varnish job. So now I'm going to glue the cannons to the lower deck. That's four here and four on the other side. And I'm going to get back to you to start making the gun port lids. So guys, as you see, I have glued the four cannons and also the four on the other side. I do not believe it's visible from here. And I have made a test run to see how it goes, and it goes very well. So let's do another one together. Let's do the next one. As you can see, I'm opening holes exactly at the lower part of the rubbing strake above, and I'm going to continue in the same order, no matter what the height. I'm going to open small 0.9 millimeters holes exactly above the every lid in the lower part of the rubbing strake, because also here at the rubbing strake later it's going to be every dead eye, every axle of the dead eye is going to be laid down here. So I want to interfere as less possible as I can. One more thing. I have opened up again the holes I have from the varnish. The holes here are 0.8. I'm drilling 0.9 to have more room to apply the thread, to insert the thread, sorry. And I have also opened up these holes and made them 1.5 from 1 millimeter that there was, because inside here it's going to be past 0.5, a double 0.5 wire. So 1.5, it's okay. But enough talking. Let's do some work. I'm lining up each metallic part of this lid, and I'm doing a small hole very, very, very carefully. I don't have to go all the way, just enough to drill the rubbing strake to have a visible hole. Now, the thread I'm using is this, it's left over. I believe it's 0.5, very common. First of all, I'm going to make a simple knot. I'm going to secure it with a drop of glue. Cut off the excess. And I believe this much is enough. Now, with this ingenious tool that I have used before many times, and I'm going to use again and again and again, I'm going to pass the thread through here. Just some measurement to see where to cut. Insert the thread in the hole. That means that the hole is open. Need some cutting. Stupid hole. Some glue. Ready. Let's do the next one. It's big. So that's the idea, and I think it's very, very beautiful. So, let me do them all, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done. One side, that is. I have one more side to go. But it looks kind of empty. So, let's add cannons only to the lower part, because up here, we're going to play some dead dice. But no, no problem. I will add cannons over there too. So let me add cannons to both sides. Nothing difficult about that. As you can see, the holes already made up. The lower part takes these big ones, the lower row, and the upper row, this row, takes these ones. So, okay, if you think that it is wrong, you just have to count them. These are 30, I need 28, these are 22, I need 22. So, okay, these are 22, and the lower are 28. Both sides, of course. So let me add them and get back to you to show you the finishing result. That's one side, guys. I have the other side as well, but the result is stunning. And I haven't placed the upper tech cannons yet. It looks so beautiful. Here we're missing some chains, also the lights, the lamps, but look at that. I believe if it had gun lights on the upper side, on the upper deck, it would be even more beautiful. But now it's a big trouble to make them. And also, I'm going to destroy the varnish a lot. So guys, thank you very much for watching. I have to do the other side as well, like I said, but that's okay. That's something that it will be done. Join me to the next video, because I believe in the next video I'm going to make the final touch in the stern, making the lamps, also add the chain, and probably add the cannons to the upper deck. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon.